What is going on, everyone? I am Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. I'm glad that you're back with me today because I've got an accessory for you to check out. This is an accessory that which really allows you to scale your creativity. Maybe you have a MacBook Pro, maybe you have a Mac Mini. For sure, you probably have an iPad Air or an iPad Pro. And really, those devices are limited by the number of devices that you can connect to it. Maybe you want to connect more than one hard drive. Maybe you want to go ahead and charge your device while also connecting an external display and a hard drive. This is something that is going to solve those problems for you. This is the Owc Thunderbolt 4 dock from Otherworld Computing. This is $249. It was announced at CES 2021. I pre-ordered then and I received maybe a few days ago. It's not really available in mass quantities, but they are doing pre-orders at this moment. If you're looking to pick one up, I'll put a link down in the description below. Now, what makes this dock unique is that, first of all, there are four Thunderbolt 4 ports on here. It is backwards compatible with Thunderbolt 3, so you don't necessarily need to get new peripherals. It is also compatible with USB 4, which is a new standard, and it'll work with not just Macs, but also PCs as well. This is really a lot to offer. It's $249, so in today's video, we're gonna take a look at it, unbox it, tell you at the end of the video whether you should purchase it or not. Let's get started. Now, while we are opening this up, just to make sure that you and I are on the same page, this video is not sponsored by Owc. This is not paid for by Owc. I bought this using my own money, and Owc has no editorial control in the content that we're going to talk about today. Matter of fact, they're watching this video at the same time you are, so this is not a paid review. Second thing is that if you like this type of content, whether it's Mac accessories, iPad accessories, accessory builds, make sure you are subscribed, turn on notifications, because you don't want to miss the next video. So let's take this out of the box here, and this is what we see. This is the actual dock itself. It's actually nicely sized. We have the SD card reader on the front, which is UHS 2, a USB 2.0 port, 40 gigabits per second of data to and from your Mac. And this is actually going to be the cable or the port here that plugs in to your Mac and charges it up to 90 watts. Now on the back, we have the DC in. We have three additional Thunderbolt ports, which is unique. This is the first Thunderbolt dock that I've seen that has a total of four Thunderbolt ports. Most of them only have three usually. There's gigabit Ethernet and three USB-A ports here on the back. Now the Thunderbolt 4 dock from Owc will connect to any Mac. It doesn't matter if it's an Intel-based Mac, if it's an Apple Silicon Mac, it'll connect to a PC. It's all about being Thunderbolt 4 compliant, which is really just the rationalization of Thunderbolt 3 and USB 4. Now this will go ahead and provide 90 watts of pass-through power, so it's just not enough for the newer 16-inch MacBook Pros that require 96 watts, but you should still be able to plug in the charger that came in with your Mac. Now, the unique feature about this dock is that even though it's Thunderbolt 4, it is backwards compatible with Thunderbolt 3 and USB 4. So what that means is because the interface technology is USB-C, you can take this dock and plug in your iPad Pro, iPad Air 4, and it will charge your iPad. If you have a display that's connected to it that's USB-C, like this LG UltraFine monitor that I have here, it'll go ahead and output the iPad to that display. So it's giving you the ability to connect many different interfaces, accessories to this, and still take advantage of the dock. So not saying that you would buy this dock because you have an iPad, but if you have, you know, an iPad and a MacBook or an iPad and a Mac Mini, it's something that is multi-use and you could use it between many different machines. Now, still, Apple has not fixed the problem where you're not getting full display resolution on your external display, but hopefully they fix that sometime very soon. Maybe we're gonna get that this fall in iPad OS 15. Inside the box, you're gonna have a few things. One, a quick reference guide that's gonna show you how to go ahead and get set up. Two, you're gonna have this ginormous charging adapter to go ahead and get started here. And you're gonna have a Thunderbolt 4 cable that is 2.6 feet long. Now again, Thunderbolt 4 is backwards compatible with Thunderbolt 3. This is really about standardization and making sure that PCs can get all the same features that us Mac users have been using for a very long time. The reason why I bought the Owc dock is because I needed to replace my existing Thunderbolt dock, and this is the CalDigit TB3. This is a great dock. I actually got it, I think maybe around Christmas time, I was able to purchase this. And as great of a dock this is, there is a couple limiting factors which impact my workflow, which is the reason why I wanted to get the TB4 dock. There are only two Thunderbolt ports on here, which for me, I needed more than that because every accessory I have on my desk is a Thunderbolt accessory and connected to my iPad. That is also a great benefit to me. Next, what we will do is we will take a look at the Owc dock side by side against the CalDigit TB3, compare the features of each one. So here we have a UHS Type 2 card reader, which is going to be the same here. There's a USB 2.0 slot here on the front, which is going to be the same here. We have a USB-C port, which is also going to give you the same speed. This does have the headphone jack out and the speaker out, while this only has the headphone out. But here we have that Thunderbolt 4 port, which is going to be able to transfer data to your device at 40 gigabits per second, as well as charge your device up to 90 watts. Now here on the back, we have the gigabit Ethernet port, gigabit Ethernet port. We have a USB-C at 10 gigabits, four USB-A ports at 5 gigabits, and then two USB-C ports. This does have DisplayPort out, and this does have optical audio out. However, neither of those things are really of any use in this setup that I have. I really need all the connectivity that I have, which is why I chose this. So at the end of the day, you have to ask yourself, is it worth spending $249 on the Owc Thunderbolt 4 dock? If you are maybe getting your first dock, you're replacing a dock, here are the things that I would think through. So obviously I'm gonna have a machine that supports Thunderbolt and I'm gonna be comfortable spending the $250. I think that goes without saying. If your workflow contains, you know, several different USB-C accessories, several different Thunderbolt accessories, and you always find yourself unplugging one and plugging the other in, that's a pain in the butt. You might wanna consider this. I think this is a good purchase. If you have a multi-device workflow where you have a Mac Mini or maybe a Mac Pro, and use an iPad, or you want to switch between them and still access the same drives, this is a good workflow because, again, it's going to be a single point. In my connection here, I have my Thunderbolt dock connected to my Mac Mini. I have my Mac Mini connected to my display. And then I have several devices daisy chained off the dock here, including my Bolt 3, which is like my scratch drive, and my RAID drive, which I do all my backups on. So if you have that kind of workflow where you need access to all these different peripherals, drives, whatever the case is, this is a good thing to go ahead and combine them and use a single cable as the connection to your device. Now, let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. My name is Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV. Folks, I'll talk to you the next one. First of all, there are four Thunderbolt 4. Now, the charging port on here will go ahead and connect. Yep, nope. I would love if Apple would fix the freaking output resolution problem on here, which for me, I needed more than that because One, two, three.